Now we move on to the third paper of this session. The paper is by Srimati Lavanya Ishwar. She is also a research associate in the Kuppuswamy Shastri Research Institute, Chennai. Her topic, the topic of her paper is Vasishtha Samhita on Vayus and Marmasthanas. Words of introduction about Srimati Lavanya. She is a research scholar pursuing her PhD in the field of Advaita Vedanta. She has also done her MA and MPhil in Sanskrit from the University of Madras. She is also well versed in Carnatic music. So I welcome Srimati Lavanya Ishwar to kindly present her paper.
Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Good afternoon to one and all present here. My paper is on the Vasishtha Samhita on Vayus and Marmasthanas. Indian classical thoughts hold salvation, Kaivalya, as the highest of the ideals of human endeavor. It also holds that yoga is the only way of attaining the same, as is seen in many scriptural passages like Ayam tu paramo dharmo yad yogyena atmadarshanam and so on. On considering such passages, it can be definitely said that a traditional system of yoga existed from times of yore and was accepted by the Vedic sages. The Vasishtha Samhita, especially the Yoga Kanda, is one such small and unique text on yoga in 6 chapters. The Vasishtha Samhita describes yoga with the 8 limbs, but the method of treatment of this differs from that of the other yoga texts. First, I will give a short account of the unique features of the text and then go on with the Vayus and Marmasthanas. Works on yoga, including the Yoga Shastra, Yoga Sutra and the Hatha Pradipika, are generally silent on the question whether the injunctions laid down by the Shruti and the Smriti are to be followed. But the Vasishtha Samhita is not silent in this matter. It gives the aspirant a definite injunction that the duties prescribed by the Vedas are to be followed. Jnanino agnanino vapi yavad dehasya sadhanam tavad varnashrama proktam kartavyam karma muktaye. The famous works on yoga do not prescribe the performance of daily and other duties. The Vasishtha Samhita, on the other hand, lays down 2 ways for the performance of the rituals. At first, it divides karma into 2 as pravartaka and nivartaka. The 2 ways of performing them, namely pravartaka marga and nivartaka marga, depend on the positive actions as indicated in the verse. Jatasya dvidau jnayau panthanau vedachoditau karmatmaka ubhavetau pravartaka nivartakau. Varnashramanam karmaiva kama sankalpa purvakam pravartakam bhavedetat samsarevai pravartanat. As both ways of positive action, it becomes evident that Vasishtha does not approve of karma sannyasa or renunciation of all actions. When karma is performed with a special motive in mind, it gives rise to samsara and hence is known as pravartaka. But karma, if it is performed because it is one's duty and without hankering for its fruit, it becomes nivartaka. Combination of jnana and karma. In the opinion of Vasishtha, jnana or karma alone would not lead to salvation. It is only a combination of both, that is the correct path of leading, correct path leading to the goal. Karma along with jnana not only purifies the mind but also leads one to moksha. This is the jnana karma samuchaya vada, which was in vogue in ancient times and referred to in scriptures. Vasishtha leans heavily on this view, as can be seen from the verse yataha karmaiva kurvanti jnaninopi mumukshavah tatas tvamapi viprendra jnanena achara karma tat. Jnana equated with yoga. Of the two, namely jnana and karma, jnana has been explained by Vasishtha prominently. Jnana means knowledge, but all types of knowledge do not form the means to salvation, according to Vasishtha. Only that knowledge of oneself acquired through yoga forms the means to salvation, which is stated below. Jnanam yogatmakam viddhi yogas chatmani tishtati sa yogo ashtanga samyuktaha sarvadharma sa uchyati. Thus, yoga with the 8 limbs is jnana. One should have a good knowledge of the physical body and also the subtle and astral bodies in order to lead a life in harmony with nature and to live a balanced life. If one has defect in the physical body or the mind, then it is difficult for him to achieve human perfection through the yogic practice. Hence, great yogis and saints of ancient India emphasized the need for a comprehensive knowledge of the physical and mental activities of a person. Yoga Yajnavalkya contains description on the physical and subtle bodies, nadis, vayus and their functions, which are found in many popular texts like Hatha Yoga Pradipika, Hataratnavali, Goraksha Samhita, Shiva Samhita and Gairanda Samhita. It may be pointed out that Hatha Sanketa Chandrika is the only text which describes all aspects of physical and subtle bodies, and sometimes it quotes Yoga Yajnavalkya and also Vasishta Samhita, Atma Purana and Manasolaso of Sureshwaracharya on this topic. The Vasishta Samhita contains insightful information on human anatomy in terms of nadi, vayu, marmasthana, unique practice of pratyahara in terms of vital points, enlightening instructions on dharana and dhyana from yogic point of view, which facilitates the attainment of yogic goal. The eight limbs of yoga described in the Yoga Sutra are dealt by Vasishta also, but he adds to this the topic on the purification of the nadis. The position of the various nadis and their working are described at first, followed by the description of the mode of purification. To have a correct knowledge of the purification of nadis, knowledge of the various parts of the body and of the passage of the vayus in the nadis is essential. According to the many texts on yoga, there are 10 different vayus inside the body. They are located at different places and perform different functions to maintain the body without diseases. The 10 vayus are prana, apana, samanascha, udano, vyana, evacha, nagaha, kurmaha, krikarako, devadatto, dhananjayaha. The first 5 are known as panchaprana and the later 5 are upapranas. Even in the early Vedic Samhitas and Upanishads, references on the 5 main pranas are available. Vasishta Samhita also describes the 10 vayus moving through the nadis. Ete nadishu sarvasu charanti dashavayavaha, eteshu vayavaha pancha mukhyaha pranadayaha smritaha. Their respective regions in the body and the functions they perform with respect to Yoga Yajnavalkya and Vasishta Samhita, I have presented this in a tabular form. Yoga Yajnavalkya and Vasishta Samhita, if you see, are almost similar in bringing out the locations of the vayus as well as the functions. Now, this table shows the location of the vayu. Teshu mukhyatamaha pranaha kandasyadaha pratishtitaha charatyasye nasikayor hridaye nabhimandale padangushtepi saprana eteshvapi cha tishtati. Now, in the second chapter of Yoga Vasishta, Vasishta Samhita, verses 42 to 50 deal with the location of the vayus. And from verse 51 to 54, it deals with the location. 42 to 50 deals with the location, and 51 to 54 deals with the functions of the 10 vayus. Now, this table shows the functions of the vayus with respect to Yoga Yajnavalkya and Vasishta Samhita. Now, of the first 5 vayus that were mentioned, samana pervades the whole of the body. So, samanaha sarvada dehe sarvam vyapya vavasthitaha bhuktam sarvarasam gatre vyapaye vakhinasaha visaptati sahasreshu nadi margeshu sancharan samanavayu revaiko deham vyapya vavasthitaha jnatvevam nadi samsthanam vayusthanam prayatnataha nadi samshodhanam kuryat yathavidhi purassaram. Now, from the tables below, shown, it can be seen that both Yoga Yajnavalkya and Vasishta Samhita are almost similar in dealing with the location and movement of the vayus. Starting from Naga, that the last 5, the location of the 5 individual vayus, they have not been given separately. It is only mentioned as Nagadi Vayavaha Pancha Tvagastyadishu Samsthitaha. That is, it only says that these 5 are present in the skin and the bones, as the common location has been given as skin and bones. Now we go on to the vital points, marmasthanas. The chapter 3 of Vasishtha Samhita gives the description of the vital points in the body, beginning with describing the pratyahara. The vital points are mentioned. So pratyaharam prashamsanti samyuta yoginah sada ashtadashasu yad vayor marmasthaneshu dharanam sthanat sthanat samakrishya pratyaharah sacha uttamah. Then beginning with the 18 vital points are given. Padangushto cha gulpau cha janga madhyo tathaiva cha chityor mule cha janu cha madhye chorudvayasya cha payumulam tatav paschat madhyadeham cha medrakam nabhim cha hridayam vatsa kantakupas tathaiva cha talumulam cha nasayaha mulam chakshnosh cha madhyamam bruvor madhyam lalatam cha murdha cha munisattama marmasthanani cha etani manam tesham pratakshunu. So from verse 62 to 75 deals with the list of the 18 vital points and also as well as the measurement given. That is Vasishtha Samhita mentions the 18 vital points, giving the vertical distance of one point from the preceding one. That is with respect to the body measurement of 96 angulas for all human beings by their own fingers. Staneshveteshu manasa vayum aropya dharayet sthanat sthanat samakrishya pratyaharottamo mataha. By mentally imposing vayu on these spots, one should concentrate the air on these spots and should withdraw it from each and every place. This is supposed to be the best pratyahara. एवं कुरुते विद्वान योगमिति यता विधि सयाति ब्रह्म सदनम पुनरावर्तते ततः पुनर्नावर्तते ततः. The wise and learned person, by doing as prescribed, attains the celestial abode, never to return from there again. So this is the table. I have shown the vital points with the finger distance. This was with regard to the vayus and marmasthanas given in Vasishtha Samhita. I also thought to just bring out a small note on the philosophical thoughts of Vasishtha. Vasishtha holds the identification of Jivatma with Paramatma to be Advaita, as is clear from the characteristics of Samadhi described by him. It also becomes clear that Vasishtha attributes to Brahman all supernatural qualities and also omnipresence. He holds that Brahman with attributes is the cause of the universe. Then coming to Jiva, Jivas are the reflections of Brahman, like the reflections of the moon in the waters. To this limited Jiva is attributed transmigration. Jiva is called as Kshetrajna when in the state of waking, and is called Bhokta when he experiences good and evil. The four states described are Jagrat, Swapna, Sushupti and Turiya. The fivefold universe is stated to be Bhokta, Bhogya, Bhukti, Bhogayatana and Indriya. The Vasishtha Samhita does not contain any detailed description regarding the creation of the universe. It only states that the universe was at first unmanifest and was in a subtle form. It became manifest in the present form through Pranava. Though the duties largely differ according to the respective Varna and Ashrama, Vasishtha does not mention any particular varna as exclusively competent for practicing yoga. On the other hand, he recommends yoga to all. Jnanam yogatmakam vidhi yogaschatma nitishtati sa yogo ashtanga samyuktaha sarvadharmaha sa uchyate. Similarly, though Vasishtha describes varying degree of ahimsa and mitahara in order to suit different stages of life, nowhere does he recommend any change in the upasana and yogic practices with regard to the caste. This shows that Vasishtha recommends the path of yoga to the whole of humanity. Thank you.
Thank you very much, madam. It was a wonderful note with which you concluded that yoga is sarvadharma, means is applicable to manava matra, means for the entire humanity. I don't recollect the exact quote, but in Brahma Purana also, once I presented a paper on Purana in Ashtanga Yoga in Purana, there also we see that yoga is mentioned as Sarvadharma. It's for all without any division of Varna, Ashrama, etc. So it's a wonderful point, madam. But just have one query, that is,
yes, sir.
In Hatha Yoga Pradipika, in the beginning, there is a verse. Before commencing the description on asana, Swatmarama says, Vasishthadyaischa munibhihi, Matsyendradyaischa yogibhihi, Angikritani asanani, Kathyante kani chinmaya. That's how he commences the description on asana, where he says that Vasishtha and others are munis, Matsyendra and others are yogis. What is the difference between munis and yogis? Manana and Hathabhyasa. Okay. Both of them practice manana and Hathabhyasa. Manana is important for Vasishtha and others. They also do Hathabhyasa, whereas for yogis, the Hathabhyasa component is important. They also do manana. So that's this much of an information about Vasishtha we find from the Hatha Yoga Pradipika and Jyotsna commentary. Now, based on your study on Vasishtha Samhita, can you throw some light on the author himself or Vasishtha himself as a yogin? Are there any references, descriptions, more inputs on Vasishtha as a yogi, or when this period, when this text has emerged? Because Vasishtha is a Vedic sage in our tradition, known in Ramayana also.
Yes, sir. One second, sir.
Yeah. Dr. Jayaraman, sorry to interrupt. Vasishtha instructs so many things in Yoga Vasishtha also.
True.
There are so many points on pranayama and other techniques described in Yoga Vasishtha. So, Vasishtha was, if we believe the same Vasishtha was there, as we say, the same Yajnavalkya was there in Yoga Yajnavalkya. We have to believe that these things were there.
And I just wanted to know any more inputs about the Vasishtha who is associated with Vasishtha Samhita. Very true, sir, what you say.
Yeah, but sir, the text that I am following, there is a chronology with regard to the date of, the chronological information with regard to the text. But the edition that I have seen, nothing they have mentioned in particular about the author Vasishtha. The discussion is there on the regarding the date of the text. Somewhere earlier to, somewhere after the 12th century AD is the chronology of the text, of the origin of the text. Particular as with regard to the author, sorry sir, I couldn't get any information.
Now, in Yajnavalkya Samhita, we see that as a conversation between Yajnavalkya and Gargi.
Yes.
Is this also in the form of a conversation?
Yes, yes, sir. Yes, yes. The conversation dialogue between Vasishtha and his son Shakti.
Okay.
It's the form of a dialogue.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.